dynamics cam. Let's bring up our base LP560 template, and let me show you how you go about applying a dual rate approximation. So we'll click on the damper tab. Now, as you can see, this is a nonlinear damper. Now, the key thing is when you want to do quick fire damper approximations, remember everything we talked about with damping rate, how that drives damping behavior? That's what these little puppies here are. These, remember the damping rates we talked about in newtons per meters per second? It's all here. So how do we translate this nonlinear damper and pretty much plug the numbers in here? So the way that we do that is all that we have to do is that we look at the damper and we see where the crossovers are between the low speed section of the damper and the high speed section of the damper. So here what we've got is we've got the zero point here, and you can see up to about 80 mil, that's pretty much where the low speed section of the damper is. Sure, there's a little bit of a kick here, but remember the beauty about the dual rate model is it gives you the ability to do quick fire changes. So the whole idea is that you figure out where you're going with using these, and then you go back to use the nonlinear lookup table to refine what you're after. So in this particular case, and I did these numbers beforehand, I went to about the 80 mil point and simply went 896 divided by 0.08, and the numbers there are about, if my memory serves me correctly, are about 10,000. But for those of you who've got calculators, I'll let you fill in the blanks. Now, to fill in the high speed component, I went from 320 mil to 80 mil, so that's a, so that is a difference of 0.24 of a meter per second, 240 millimeters per second, and I simply went 1806 minus 896, and that's about 900. So it's 900 divided by 0.24. That's about 4,000. So we put 4,000 here, and you do exactly the same for the rebound, except here the rebound's about 40. So we go 40 there, and we go 619, divide that by 40, and I'll pull out my trusty calculator. There's an old saying, never let engineers loose with big numbers. And that's about 15,474. And we go from 40 mil, which is 619, to 2652. So that's a delta of 2652 minus 619. And it's 320 minus 440. Now remember, we've got to convert that into what it would be in meters per second. So you multiply, as you divide that by 1,000. Divide, so 2033 by 0.28, and that's 7260. 7260, click that to 1, click on OK, and if we go back to the actual damper itself, there you go. So it's not perfect, but it gets you, that's not perfect. Ah, the reason it appeared so weird is because I made a mistake, and I should have put that as 40. My apologies. So we'll click on OK, and that just shows you how easy it is to correct if you do make an error. So now we've got a very good linear approximation of what the actual damper is. Now, it's not perfect, but the whole point is that we can now start to do really quick fire changes here, 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 and here to see what the damper is doing. And that's a very powerful tool, ladies and gentlemen. So now what I did was I ran up some changes. I ran up some changes earlier. And let me walk you through what it did. Okay, the actual base car had very borderline understeer characteristics. So what I wanted to do was almost to the point where it was neutral steering. So what I did was I increased the front bump, and what that did, as you can see here, the actual baseline steer was 5.96 degrees, and in the transition period it went to about 6.17 degrees. Baseline was colored, the bump change where I increased the low speed front bump to try and induce some understeer was black, and as you can see, there's a marginal increase. Now, that, ladies and gentlemen, will actually show you two things. Yes, it achieved the desired result, But because it's a simulator change, it's not going to be a praise be Jesus, hallelujah change. Now, what was actually quite interesting is that actually lost lap time. And the reason it lost lap time is by increasing the front bump, and because this was on a bumpy circuit, it increased the contact patch load variation at the front. However, I did it more just to see what a handling change was going to do. And also, too, what I then did, so the next change that we evaluated using the dampers was a rear bump change. Now here, again, when I looked at the transition between the comparison between actual steer and neutral steer, the problem was it was borderline understeer going towards neutral steer. So what I wanted to do was to explore giving the car a little bit more traction and a little bit more understeer under turn exit. So what I did was that I decreased the rear bump just to allow the car to sit down, a little bit lower. And as you can see here, what we've got here, the baseline steer was 5 degrees. So once we're actually in that turn exit situation, is 5.08 degrees. The new steer with the lower rear bump was about 6 degrees. And as you can see, particularly here, once we actually get into the mid-corner exit, the baseline was colored, the change was black. We've just got a little bit more compression at the rear, just giving us just that tad more of understeer. But again, just showing you, again, this is a simulated change, just how subtle those changes are. The other thing to note with both the rear bump change and the front bump and the rear bump change and the front bump change is just how subtle these changes actually are, which shows you that the damper is a great tool to fine-tune the change. However, it's not going to be the hallelujah be praised change, which harks back to an earlier point that we discussed, that sometimes you can fall into the trap of trying to get a damper to do a job which actually it's not actually built for. So bear that in mind. So some conclusions and parting thoughts. The thing that counts with dampers is damping rate. That's absolutely key, ladies and gentlemen. Remember, the quarter car model is a very handy tool to quantify your dampers. And remember, the dual rate model in ChassisSim is about to become your best friend. Remember, we tune for the frequency response and the overall contact patch load variation first, and this will dictate our base damper curve. And then you use the low speed rates to fine tune the response. If you do that, ladies and gentlemen, you're in a very, very strong position. And if you're not a member of the ChassisSim community, explore this for yourself. Check out our online simulation, and we'll catch you in the next episode of Dan's Vehicle.